In this video, I'd like to show you how to use Google Labs, which is a way of adding extra features to your email that aren't there by default. So, here's how we do it. From your main email page here, you go up to the little gear wheel in the corner, which is getting a bit of a workout, and go to Mail Settings. And it takes you into this page. And you'll see along the top here where all the categories are, there's one called Labs. Just give that a click, and it will take you in there. Now, what Labs are is, as Google call it, some crazy experimental stuff. But Labs are really just extra features you can add to your mail service that aren't there out of the box. So your standard Gmail does all the usual things a mail client should do. It sends mail replies, forwards, adds attachments. It does all that sort of thing. But you can actually add extra features to your mail to make it more usable for you. And that's what Labs is all about. Now, they do make a little point up here that they are kind of experimental features and they may change or break or disappear at any time. Yeah, they can, although generally speaking, these are pretty stable. So feel free to experiment, and you can always turn them off. So I've got some here. These are the ones I've enabled, and if I scroll down the page, you'll see some that are disabled. So I won't spend too long doing this because you can read for yourself. Each one has a little description next to about what it does, and you can choose to enable or disable it. So, for example, here's one called Background Send. This one lets Gmail send your mail while you move on to more important things, just as long as you stay logged in. In other words, when I get to the end of my email and I press Send, it will happily go and send, and I can go and do something else while it's still sending in the background. So that's kind of a useful feature. I've enabled that. Some other useful ones are things like being able to insert an image into an email, which is a good thing to be able to do. So you can enable that. There's also things like the preview pane. If you are a Gmail user who liked the fact that Outlook gave you that panel on the right, which showed the actual message contents as you picked it from the list, preview pane will give you that feature back. And so on and so on. So there are a bunch of really useful ones there. Undo send is a great one. You can tell it to give you 5 seconds, 10 seconds, 20 seconds or 30 seconds, I believe it is, between the time that you hit the send button and the time that it actually sends the message. And so you can have that little window of time to change your mind if you need to pull something back. So I would recommend you take a look through here. If I go down here, you'll see these are the available labs. These are the ones I have not turned on. And for no particular reason, they're just not ones that grab me that I don't feel I need. So by all means, you can turn anything on or off in here that you like. You simply make sure you, at the end of choosing the labs that you want, make sure you click the Save Changes button. So if I make a change here and say disable that, I would have to make a save change. You'll find a Save Changes button here at the top of the list and also one right down at the bottom of the page at the bottom of the list. So knock yourself out with Labs and have a bit of a play with them. There's some really cool features in there.